Before I get started in the subject of this video, I want to point out an error I made in yesterday's video. I talked about the ninth tooth that Gibways caused me to have this affliction with, and it's actually not the ninth. There's nine teeth that he caused me to post to the right hand as you're going into the shed there at Zion, but the dual double doors, the right hand of those dual double doors of his Ezekiel chapter, his first day of the 10th day of the first month, excuse me, prophecy, starting in chapter 40. But anyway, those dual double doors, but it's to the left hand when you are leaving. And that's how Solomon reckoned the pillars, Yakin and Boaz, because we're told that Yakin is to the right hand, but it's to the south, and Yahweh's house faces the east. Therefore, it would be as you leave the door. So it's to the left hand of those dual double doors of his end time son of Adam prophecies. Pretty amazing. Those nine teeth that he's caused me to post, and I haven't talked about why he caused me to post them, but because of a hireling. When a hireling goes out, if he don't want to go out, he bores his ear to the door of his master's house. And symbolic, when that first one, for it ain't the ninth tooth I've lost in my life, it's the ninth I've lost during the time of Zion. So been amazing journey. He caused me to, but anyway, it's number 10 and 11, the 10 on the left side of my mouth, and number 11 started up a few days later on the right side. But number 10, 11, that ties into his 904 Zechariah waypoint, which would be 10 and 11 on Satan's calendar coming up. But anyway, I'll move on. There's much more to that. But when I checked before I started the upload of this video, the recording of this video, I checked Steamboat, and Steamboat number 118 still has not went off. And as of 9 days, I think it was 9 days, 23 hours, and 1 minute. Perhaps it'll go off here in 9 days and 24 hours for the 924 waypoint, but we'll see. But if it goes off today, this is amazing what I'm getting ready to tell you, and I'll expand upon it as we go on in this video. But if it does go off today, I did the calculations for what those three calculations that I do for each of these now, 117 eruptions, soon to be 118. For Psalms 118, I will circumcise them, I will circumcise them, I will circumcise them. Prophecy, one of the prophecies that say I'm not going to die. But those three calculations yield the number 411. Wow. Operation Grapes of Wrath, 411, 1996. The Danites set forth those 16 days of Operation Grapes of Wrath against the Lebanon, the White Mountain. How it ties into Yahweh's White Mountain at this time is amazing. Matter of fact, even Zion is located in the foothills of the White Mountains. Anyway, truly amazing. 16 days of Operation Grapes of Wrath. But anyway, in doing the first calculation and the second, it ties into, it's 926 today on Satan's calendar, so it goes back to 926 on the great Mahershala Kushbaz Mir on Yahweh's restored calendar last year, the year 6000, year of the ram's horn, release of debts. That day was 11-8 on Satan's calendar, 11-8, Steamboat 118. But anyway, Steamboat number 7535 went off that day. Huge, with these 35 days of my toothache affliction, I believe. Today's day number 33. We'll see how it all works out. But there's so much more to that day than that. I mean, that was the day that I had my Saul Tarsus, Saul King Saul moment, like David, where those that hunt me down, one of them walked right by me. Couldn't even see me. Amazing. Me and the wife. Anyway, just right there. Walked right by us. Yet we let his dog see me. Growled. He's like, come on, Titan, let's go have some fun. He's following our tracks, trying to find us. Anyway, truly amazing. The whole thing is amazing. I'm going to get into the significance of the 16 days here with today's Supreme Court announcement. But first, I want to point out that 4/11/1996 plus 8,934 days. There's not 8,934 Strong's numbers, so we're out of the Strong's number at 8674, I think, for Tatnay. But anyway, Strong's number 8934 divided by 3 for these 3 days that are left to 822 and for other things too, comes to 2,978. Well, Strong's number 2,978 comes from 857, meaning to arrive. He was going to arrive with his myriads of his holy ones and such. But 2978 is only used one place, and it's in Ezekiel 40, that 10th day of the first month prophecy for those measurements. But it's referring to the entrance. It's one of the words for interest, but it's not interest because it's to arrive, the arrival, so it is interest. But from the entrance of Yahweh's house to the, from the faces of the entrance to of the gate to his house, to the faces of the porch, and that ties into things amazing too, those five porches, plus 50 cubits. And that ties into 7-1 plus 50 days being 8-21, which is huge the day before, but I'm not going to go into all that, but I thought that was significant. Anyway, back to the 16. An operation Grapes of Wrath, those 16 days. Day number, today is 8-19 on our Maker's Restored calendar. 8-19 is always day number 229, the day that he caused me to be arrested last year. This year, the ram's horn release of debts. Tied in the pomegranate wine with those license plates 229 and other things as well. But day number 229 plus 16 days is his 9-5, 266 day for the faithful witnesses. And I'm going to get to the significance of that here in a little bit too. Faithful witnesses, Zechariah and Uriah. Truly amazing, 16 days from today. Because there's also 16 bottles left when we get to 7:34 a.m. on 8-8. There'll be 16 bottles left of the King of Kings, those 172 bottles that became 170 when I used two of them to fulfill Genesis 49 and Isaiah 63 of washing my persuasion in the blood of the grapes. But truly amazing. But this also ties into the 16 pillars of the Supreme Court, because today, at 5 p.m. Eastern Time, Trump is supposed to announce his pick. And I said in a recent video he had four ladies, if you will, selected. But the recent article say he's got a list of five. So I don't know who the fifth one is. I never did see that. But at 5 p.m. day, 55, the signature ring and different things. But today's the fifth day of Jeroboam's profane feast. Tonight will be the fifth bottle of those eight poured out ones from Adam. By the way, the last bottle of eight poured out from Adam's is the first of those 16 bottles. But on the eighth day, all eight of these poured out was from Adam of Micah or Michael chapter 5. All eight of them line up with Jeroboam's, the 8 days of Jeroboam's profaned 7-day feast of the eighth month, 8-8. How this ties into the marking of 8-8 on his restored calendar this year at 7:40 a.m. with his Daniel 490-day prophecy and his 2300 morning evenings is irrefutably amazing. Amazing. But Trump is picking a replacement for the Synagogue of Satan's late Ruth Bader, or however you say it, Ginsburg, RBG as she's known, from the Synagogue of Satan, Danite. Says she's a rod of Judah, but it's not from, she's from the Synagogue of Satan. But she passed away on a remarkable waypoint, remarkable, 8 days prior to today, 8 days, eighth day, because this is for the ninth judge. I'm getting ahead of myself now, but this is for the ninth judge on the so-called blasphemous Supreme Court, which is blasphemous. But the ninth judge. Well, today is also the eighth day of his ninth messenger of blood. Talk about the nine teeth that are in this dual double doors a bit ago. But the synagogue, he's going to replace the Synagogue of Satan. And reporting is he's going to do it with somebody, one of those five, and I think at least two of them are from the mother whore of Babylon, the Roman Catholic whorehouse, where all of her daughter whores, Christianity, came out from. The mother whore of Babylon. From the Synagogue of Satan to the mother whore of Babylon. Amazing. But from Dan to Beersheba, the well of sevens, the mother whore of Babylon, they really don't care when you do the Sabbath. Matter of fact, the one that's supposedly going to be picked is this Amy Barrett, but she's heavily involved, and even actually with zeal in the mother whore of Babylon. And the lady from Cuba too is, I think, the mother whore of Babylon as well. But she's involved in a charismatic group. I don't want to go there with the Pentecostal stuff nonsense, blah blah blah, and calling a group called People Praise. I'm not going to go into all that. But in her confirmation hearing for the Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals, of course, probably know, most of you probably read the articles with Dianne Feinstein saying the dogma lives loudly in you or whatever, but I'm not going to all that because, believe me, she's just as deceived. Dianne Feinstein is just as deceived as this lady and just as all of you. It's just what it is. Just as deceived as is Ginsburg. I mean, but Ginsburg's position, being a Danite, did it change? Did Danites supposedly keep some form of Yahweh's law? Did it affect her rule? No. Just murder babies, whatever. But now this woman's against the murder and the babies, of course. And of course, that's why they're going to try to. They got to be those. The left's got to be able to kill their babies. So of course, they're going to do everything they can to keep her from getting onto this court. But you got some news for you. Don't matter. Doesn't matter who he selects, because nothing's going to come of it. Because Yahweh's judge is standing before your faces. But the point I want to make is that they're blasphemous hypocrisy. But during that confirmation process, she said to her accusers, basically, she said, "My religion, yes, I'm deeply convicted, but it won't affect my job to judge as a judge." How can that be? How can your yeah? how, if you, first of all, if you believe his word is true, how can you stand by any other law besides the straight and narrow pathway? His straight and narrow pathway, his word is Torah. That's just crazy. From Dan to Beersheba, from the synagogue of Satan to the mother whore Babylon, it don't matter. It don't matter who they select. It could get an atheist in there. It doesn't matter, folks. There is no righteousness in this world except for Yahweh's anointed, as far as his judge that he's chosen and plucked from your midst, clothed in filthy garments to clothed in my persuasion, that from clothed in filthy garments to clothed in my persuasion being washed in the blood of the grapes. It's just what it is. Because righteousness, it ain't going to matter if you put me on that board, which I don't need no board of nine, because there's only one. But if I was on that board, I guarantee you I would be against everything, every one of them. Nine justices, eight now, justices stand for. And every other justice that's been a justice on that blasphemous court that's called the Supreme Court, with those eight pillars out in front of that building. Amazing, those eight pillars. Here we are, moving toward Jeroboam's eighth day. Well, of sevens, what did Jeroboam do? He profaned Yahweh's appointed times by moving his feast of his 7-day feast of the seventh month to the eighth month. And undoubtedly, of course, having the eighth day of that feast, just like the Danites do now, and it's a 7-day feast, whatever people in Christianity but do some form of the feast. The eighth day's part of the feast. It's not part of the feast unless the feast is extended to 14 days, folks, which has only happened in the five times in the history of mankind, as at least prescribed by Yahweh's word. Solomon, when he dedicated that first house that Yahweh caused to be built unto his name, and the four consecutive feasts that have happened in the seventh month and the here and the now. Four 14-day feasts. Then you can have a true eighth-day Sabbath. Otherwise, it's just an eighth day. But truly, Marcus, but her zeal is off the charts, this Amy Barrett, but it don't matter. And if it picks the Cuban, I was going to wait till after. It'd be 2 p.m. Arizona time. I was going to wait till after then to see who he selects. But you know, I got thinking, it doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter. Because it don't matter from what cesspool Trump drew his pick from for that ninth judge. But it is fascinating that this is Ruth's eighth day of being dead, and it's the eighth day of the wife that has fled in the wilderness upon the dual wings of a great eagle. To bring forth the Emmanuel man-child, Meher Shalal Kushbaz, a great vulture. But anyway, it's her eighth day. She's clean today of her ninth messenger blood. All that's amazing. Judge number nine being replaced. Wow. All that's truly remarkable. But this lady, I think she went to school in Notre Dame, if I remember right, this Barrett lady. I know she taught there, and I think she went to school there. But she talked to some graduating class there. She gave a speech a couple years ago. I don't know. I don't pay much attention to the details. But to these grads from there, and at least from law school, and she said, your law degree here is just a means to the kingdom of Elohim. Of course, she didn't say Elohim, but the kingdom of Elohim. Say what? If that was true, and the G-guy of Christianity was the Elohim of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, do you need a law degree to practice man's law that trumps Yahweh's law? I'm going to keep in mind that arrest day, 229 last year. Before that, I went there on 223 to meet with him, and I unzipped my book. He said, I'm going to shut you off right there. Wouldn't even let me show him the evidence. I said, this is the law. He said, well, that is a law, but man's law trumps it. He doesn't use the word trumps it, but that's what he said. Man, we got to obey man's law. We got to obey man's law when it tells us to rebel against Yahweh's law. Now, of course, we want to obey man with the laws like you shall not murder, because it's the same. And, of course, speeding tickets and stuff, they're given speed limits are for a reason, to protect lives. I mean, so there's a certain degree of things, yes. I mean, but not whenever man's law tells you that you've got to get off Yahweh's holy mountain, for instance, when he commands me to be there. He commands you to be there three strokes a year, too, each of you. All males should appear three strokes a year. And of course, their wives and their daughters come with them. But anyway, it's just what it is. Wow, but Notre Dame, she said it's a means to the kingdom of Elohim. Really? You need a law degree? No, I would say Yahweh's straight and narrow path is a means to his kingdom, and there is no other. As a matter of fact, I won't even say it. I'll protest it. Because his straight and narrow path is the only means into his kingdom. No law degree. But it's amazing, today's timing of this, with it being 3 days out from 8:22, is all huge, very important. But Notre Dame means Our Lady. Well, of course, referring to Mary, but of course they worship Mary, which they shouldn't. Mary, of course, was quite the virgin. But there's another virgin. There's one that's bringing forth the second Emmanuel. His name is Mahershala Kushbash. Yahweh, make haste to plunder them, hurry to spoil them. Reality is, she became a virgin, which is what we have to do in order to enter into his kingdom. And we become a kingdom by what we become a virgin to him, a chaste virgin to him, by being a chaste virgin under his word, our relationship, walking with him on his straight and narrow pathway. There is no other means into his kingdom. My religion. Yeah, I'm convicted in my religion. I'm very got a lot of zeal and everything. I'm in this charismatic movement and everything. But you know what? It ain't gonna get in the way of my being a judge. Or, well, I'm a Danite from the synagogue of Satan. Yeah, but you know what? It ain't gonna get in the way of being a judge. Obviously, her 27 years on the bench as a justice of that blasphemous Supreme Court proved it. Her record proved that she had no regard in her heart for Yahweh's straight and narrow pathway. No regard. And neither does this Justice Barrett or any of the rest of them. So what are you going to do? Who are you going to vote for? Talk about voting for Biden or Trump. If I were you, I'd vote for Yahweh's anointed. But I ain't going to need your vote because this ain't up for votes. But I would vote for me in your heart. That's who I'd be voting for. Because the rest of it's all a bunch of just filthy, polluted nonsense. But anyway, Notre Dame, 229, the rest waypoint. As the rest of the year, 530 days ago. But 229 was the Notre Dame Cathedral. We set the fire the day I was arrested. You got to be kidding me. Notre Dame, Our Lady. And here, at that point, the lady was the younger wife. But she, when I went to prison here, she went back into Egypt. And the elder wife of Zechariah chapter 5 kept revolving around Yahweh's anointed. Actually began to revolve around me more seriously. But the cathedral fire, today here, this Notre Dame lady is probably going to be chosen to be his choice. Day number 229 on Yahweh's restored calendar. It's all about his restored calendar. Remember I said she's from Beersheba, the well of sevens. It don't really matter when the Sabbath is to her, in her heart. It could be on Sunday like her mother whore of Babylon teaches her, or whatever. You don't even have to go to a whorehouse if you don't want. Now, she probably goes faithfully. I don't know. But really, the beliefs are you don't really have to go. Just do some Hail Marys, I guess. Talk about Hail Marys, Our Lady. And believe me, I have no disrespect for Mary, the true Mary, Yeshua's mother. I just have disrespect for what the mother whore has done in lifting up her up to a place of worship, because worship, we should worship Yahweh Elohim. But 530 days ago was 229. Amazing, because Strong's number 530. And by the way, that's before I do that, I'll go. It's 17 months and 20 days. Strong's number 1720 is Dedenim. Okay, it's used one place in Isaiah 21:13. It's amazing because it's talking about the burden of Arabia and the travelers of Dedenim. And then it goes on in verse 14, because it says, the ninth son of Ishmael, his name is, I'm going to go brain dead here, but the ninth son of Ishmael, ninth son, today's, of course, about this ninth judge, ninth messenger of blood, just day number 8 today, but the ninth son of Ishmael, 9 teeth in the door, that's just a few things here, but 9 months is associated bringing forth a man-child. Anyway, we'll have to see if the phone tips over here. I might have to catch it because I barely got it anchored there. But Isaiah 21 is about that. But anyway, Ishmael's nice son. I can't believe I can't think of it. Tima. Anyway, means desert. But he, his nice son, brought waters and waters to him that has fled, and met him that's fled with bread. Wow. Because you know why I say wow is because 2 verses later in verse 16 is talking about the year of a hireling. The year of a hireling will continue. They'll continue of a year of a hireling. And I spoke about other videos about how the guy we hired to bring us our waters and food, this descendant, this inhabitant of Tima, but he started bringing us waters and food on 506 of last year. 506 is a year. Well, now we're 3 months and 18 days past. 3 months and eight, eight, three, three, 2 months and 18 days is 318, and that's the day we spoke to our ancestors out from the thick, dark cloud. But 3 months and 18 days on his restored calendar is 118 days. Steamboat 118, say what? Might be blowing right when I'm doing this video. Amazing. Or maybe right at 924. We'll see. But I believe it'll blow today. If it doesn't, it ties into 11-9, and I'm not sure if the calculation will be before 11 or not. Depends if it's before sunrise and after. I ain't gonna go into that, but 11-9 would have significance. Because then 927 last year, 6,000 would be 11-9 on Satan's calendar. But I'm not going to go into all that. But right now it's at 411 is what the number will yield if she blows today. If she blows today before midnight, the yield will yield 411. Today, on this 229th day, going back to the 229 arrest waypoint, I counted you stealing from our Maker and his house being trampled underfoot, all this stuff. Our Lady, this wife that's fled in the wilderness, to bring forth the second Emmanuel man-child, Maher Shalal Kushbaz. Get away, make haste to plunder them, hurry to spoil them. It's just what it is, folks. It's getting ready to happen. But 1720, Isaiah for Dedanim means the low country. But again, goes on to say, because the inhabitant of Timah brought waters to him that has fled and met him with bread. Verse 14. In verse 16, it says they'll continue a year according to the years of a hireling. And we've been hiring this man for 1 year, 3 months, and 18 days for 118 steamboat eruption today. If it goes today, 118. 3 months and 18 days parallel in 318 at Horeb and such. If you can't see it, that's truly amazing. I don't know what to tell you. But what about the three calculations yielding 411 for Operation Grapes of Wrath and how that ties into it? But you're getting ready to be bought low, folks. Dedanim, the low country. From the habits of Arabia and the burden of Arabia and the travelers of Dedanim. Strong's number 1720. But that's 17 months and 20 days. But 530 days, 17 months and 20 days, is 530 days on our Maker's restored calendar from 229 to Rest Waypoint, the Notre Dame Cathedral. Trump's top pick is from Notre Dame. I think she went to school there. She taught there. She gave a speech there that just showed her hypocrisy off the charts. But it means faithfulness. The faithful witness twins, Uriah and Zechariah. Sometimes it's translated truth, but it means to be faithful. To be faithful to Yahweh. Is it faithful to be a judge on the Supreme Court, whether you're from the Synagogue of Satan or from the Mother Whore of Babylon? Whether you're from Dan to Beersheba, does it matter if you don't even stand up for when his Sabbaths are? Which the Danites know they're not on Saturn's Day, by the way. From their Saturday Sabbath, is what Dan represents. They know. They go back into their Jewish encyclopedia, just back to, 1800s, I guess it was, that I had an article on the computer, which has been stolen on account of you stealing from our Maker. But I can look it up again, but they have even an article where they knew that his Sabbaths were always determined by the head of the months that they call the new moons. They knew it. But 530 days times three for these 3 days, folks, is 1,590 days. He told his servant Noah to start building the three tiers of the boat in the year 1590. Sent forth the flood 66 years later. How that ties into this with the 52 years of them building the three tiers of the boat, the eight of them building it, eight of them. Today, the eighth day of Ruth Bader Ginsburg's death, the eighth day of his ninth messenger of blood. Who could make this up? Faithfulness, 530 days today. Wow, folks. From Dan to Beersheba, from the Synagogue of Satan to the Mother Whore of Babylon. Does it matter? Does it matter who Trump selects? Who are you going to vote for? So that he could draw this out with the 1260, what he showed us recently, past 9-5. I really doubt it. These 16 bottles that start to be drank on the night of 8-22, Jeroboam's eighth day. We got the 16 days from today is 9-5. Wow, on this day that he's marked in an incredible way, doubling that 16. Folks, I've talked about some amazing things today. I've been doing it now for 1638 videos. But this has been, I've tried to talk slow, coherently, go back and listen to it again. Steamboat number 118. Wow. Especially if she blew it at 924. 9 days and 24 hours. Which would be, I guess that would be 9 days and 24 hours would be, she blew at 10:44 Arizona time, 11:44 Montana time. So it'd be 11:44 a.m. Montana time, or 10:44 Arizona time today. That would be truly spectacular. Or could just blow at 9:24. Well, actually, no, I'd already, when I checked it, it was 9:44 or something like that, when I had checked it. But it could have already blown at 9:24 a.m. because it showed it hadn't, but it sometimes takes them a while to post it. But regardless, from Dan to Beersheba, from the synagogue of Satan to the mother whore Babylon, it don't matter. What matters is there is only one means into his kingdom, and it is his straight and narrow pathway, his Torah that circumcises our hearts, that causes us, molds and fashions us in his image, the image of Elohim. There is no other way.